In the last lecture, we had discussed about different types of scholarly databases, like publisher databases, and also some data full text databases also. And also we had discussed about some academic search engines, such as scholarly search engines, such as Google Scholar. In this class, we will discuss about three important academic search engines. One is that is called Scopus, that is a kind of indexing and abstracting search engine. And we will also discuss about the another two, that is Microsoft Academic and the Dimensions. There is one more database that also we will discuss. So let's start with the Microsoft Academic. So Microsoft Academic, basically, it is a database, scholarly database, a search engine that is developed by Microsoft. And this also has very good number of publication, and coverage wise also almost 89% to 90% documents are available. Can you see this screen? No, one second. Let me share it. Yeah. So this will switch to Microsoft Academic, and until that time we'll see the Scopus later on. And Microsoft Academic is nothing but a kind of academic search engine. And academic search engine means it is basically targets only the academic resources, like for example journals, journal publication, conference proceedings, technical reports, patents, data sets like that. So specifically, like for example, if you search in a normal search engine like Google, you'll get a lot of other type of results also, general kind of results also. But here you will get only the academic scholarly articles, scholarly research that is published in this particular search engines. So in the last class we had discussed about Google Scholar, that is another search engine, academic search engine, and that has a very good coverage, and it is said that more than 90% academic documents are indexed by Google Scholar. So because it indexes everything, whatever it gets on the internet, whereas the other sources, they are rely on a source list, and that is very curated source list, and they decide that some journals should be indexed, some not should be indexed. So like that, they have a policy on which basis they index it. So you see here in this, right side, it says that more than, I think, 2 billion articles are available. And then authors, similarly, topics, they have divided in topics, 4,460 conferences, 48,000 journals are indexed, 25,565 institutions are there. So the coverage is very good of academic, Microsoft Academic Search. And also it has a state-of-the-art search information retrieval system also. That is, it says that they use power of semantic search. So you might be aware of semantic web and other concepts related to semantic search. So those are all are applicable here. So I'll start with the typing in the search bar, and then we will see other features. So for example, if I want to search quality metadata, I'm doing, say for example, research on quality of metadata. And so I said that quality, metadata quality. So in the auto suggestion box, it is giving me the different output, auto suggestions, like whichever you want to search. No, I am just interested in this one. So I'll click on the lens button. So in the top, it will show you what query it has run. And then you can modify also from here, the number of results that are basically retrieved from the system. 369 results have been retrieved. And then you can sort it by relevance. And they have another ranking called saliency. We'll discuss this later. And or you can also sort by newest, first, oldest, first, and most established citations. Means the particular document which is cited highest time that you want to sort first, that also you can do. So this is result display page. And for every result, it shows you the title, which is hyperlinked. And then the name of the journal, where it is published, year, and all the authors, and then their affiliations. the author affiliations, and it also shows the topics. Actually, they have divided everything under topics. You see related topics, topics. So you can also, seeing the topic also, you can identify whether this journal is of your relevance or not. And then you have the abstract. You can see the full abstract here, as well as then you can download this particular record, or you can share it, or you can save it to your reading list. That is like all other databases also, we have seen that you can save it, you can cite it by clicking on this, you can cite also. So likewise, you can copy APA style, Chicago style, or you can download in RIS format. That is also it can be easily seen, uploaded in the this one, easily uploaded in Zotero and other reference management software. Okay, so then this they also show the number of citation this document has received. So if I click on this particular document, I can see the record display page, and in record display page it shows the full details of the paper, how many references are there and how many citation it has got. So this paper has given 38 references and it has got 405 citations till date. And also the DOI of the article also you can get, the abstract, full abstract, then view PDF. You can also click on view PDF, and then the original website from where it is available. So it is available from Open Library, Online Library also, Digital Commons also, eprints also. And also you can claim it, you can cite it, or you can share it. And you can also see what are the different references that is given by this particular document. So it has, the record display page is very good here, you see. Apart from the Google Scholar, and a lot of other details are also provided. So in the references, you can see all the 38 references of this paper. And if you are interested, you can click on any of them and you can see the details of that particular paper. Then also you can see which are the papers who have cited this particular paper. So there are 301 items which are available in Microsoft Academic out of 405 citations. They have cited this paper. And similarly, there is one column called related. In the related one, by on the basis of some recommendation system in the background, it suggests you what are the different articles that are related to the based on some algorithm they have developed. Apart from this, if I see that you can also filter it on the basis of journal, on the basis of top institution, on the basis of authors, publication types, and the basis of top topics. You can filter it on the basis of the date, duration, like that. Similarly, in the results display page, where you see the results can also be sorted, filtered. Just like here, you can filter on the basis of the top topics. So I am interested in metadata quality only and metadata. So I can filter the records on the basis of metadata only. And also I can filter on the basis of metadata quality. So I am interested only in metadata and metadata quality. So I have selected these two. And also I am interested in information retrieval. So you see the best result I got is the continuum of metadata quality, defining, explaining and exploiting. So these are some of the ways you can filter it. You can see which are the top authors who have published in this particular area there itself. What are the, which are the top journals that are, that publish in the field of metadata quality. You see International Journal, Cataloging and Classification Quarterly, Information Tech, Journal of Library Information Science, Journal of Special, like that. You can see. And then top institutions, which are the top institutions that are working in this particular area, researchers who have qualifications in this particular area, that also you can see. And also you see here, you can also, this is another very good feature of Microsoft Academic, that it has the top conferences also. You can see which are the top conferences in this field that happen. Say for example, DCMA is very good conference, I know personally. And then JCDL is also good. And then Digital Library ACM International Conference. So you see all the good conferences are listed here. So in this way also you can filter it. So they it has some other filters like topic wise and the conference wise and top institution wise. That is very good filter here available in Microsoft Academic. And then here in this side, it is that like it has said that semantic search. So it brings out little detail about what is metadata, then parents topics, like what are the different topic that are associated with metadata. What are the child topics means narrower term. Parent topics means broader term. What are the broader term that are associated with this particular metadata quality, which I have selected here. And what are the child topics, metadata management and related topics. What are the related topics? Then based on your the particular metadata quality term, it shows parent topic, related topics, and then similarly it will show you all the related topics. And clicking on a particular topic will give results by that particular just for example, if I click on information retrieval, it shows me that there are 544,000 papers in this particular topic. They have already classified in this particular topic. And then I can see the trends also, like from 1922 onwards there is an increase, and now there is a decline in the field of publications, in the number of publications, and the top number of publications were in the field in 2014 in the field of information retrieval. So this particular field also I can analyze. Which are the top authors that have worked in this particular field, and the top journal JASIS is there, Nucleic Acid Information Processing. So all the journals which are on the top journals I can see, top conferences I can see, similarly top institutions I can see, Microsoft, Stanford University, their locations, and a very good visualization on maps also. You can see that where are these institutions located, and you can click on a particular map and zoom it, and you can see that in here 11 Cornell University. So in like that you can also zoom in and see in particular country which are the organizations that are working in this particular field. So that is also very good feature. If you are, say, for example, a scholar and you want to pursue research in the field of, say, for example, information retrieval, then you can search for this topic and see what are the different top institutions where you can go for pursuing your PhD, and what are the in a particular country, what are the particular institutions that are working in, or that are among the top research institutions in that particular field. So this is a very good interface of Microsoft Academic. So apart from papers, apart from the just papers or citations, it also provides a lot of other information also. You see here the publications are going down every year now after 2013, and also the citations also are getting down. So this also you can see. Then say for example, you are from computer science discipline, and you can see in computer science what are the trends, how the things are picking up, how the things are getting down, and like that. So it is there which are the top authors and what are the top journals in your particular field, and top conferences you can see, and then the top institutions where the research is conducting at present. Then past 10 years and last 5 years, which are the top institutions, you can filter also. So you see in last 5 years, Microsoft, Google, Chinese Academy, IBM, Massachusetts. So these all are coming up, and the last 5 year data also you can see. This bars are actually representing the number of publications where this particular line is showing the number of citations that are received in this particular field. So you see the number of publication and the number of citation the number of citations has overtaken, and you see here this side citations are given and this side the publication details are given. So that also you can analyze very well. You can share it with others also if you want to share. This is more like semantic search what they claim they have made. So for any topic you can visualize for any so the main topics from your search also they will show here. So you see if I try to implement So maybe in another 2 minutes, this session will be 8 minutes. This session will break. Then again, we will start. Okay, so I'll again start the meeting. You can join it. So,
okay, sir.
So, what I was doing? Yes. So, for example, I want to search only those articles which have metadata quality as a phrase. I'll see whether it works or not. So you see, if I search by metadata quality, it only includes the metadata qualities. Only 207 results have been retrieved. So that is another one that you can use. And if I try to use AND operator and try to use library term, means I want to assess only those metadata quality in a library perspective. That is also like I can look at. Now you see the articles are now more limited. Okay, and if I say that and OPAC by using online or public access catalog, so now you see only 98 records are there that qualify for this one, where the metadata quality as well as library and as well as OPAC is there. Okay. So you see library metadata quality, it is there, as well as somewhere in the paper OPAC must be there. That's why it is showing. So you can look at any of this one. You can see the top institutions, top conferences that publish, top journals, and then you can select your journals also. Like where you can send your articles. Okay, so this is one way that Google. This is this one Microsoft Academic, and we'll check whether it has some advanced feature is available or not. And in the first page, you can see the top authors in any field. For example, psychology, it is showing. You can click on this, and then you can select. You see in detail what are the various institutions that are working, and then engineering and everything is there. Top authors in engineering, then papers by, so upcoming conferences, which are the upcoming conferences. Then they have some blogs also that where they teach like how to conduct research and like that. And I wanted to show you they have developed something called FAQs. Okay, so you see, if you go to FAQ, it will show you like how they have designed this engine. And if you're interested in this particular field, you can see that how information retrieval and other things work. And if some of you are from computer science background, you can also look at its functioning, how it works. So it says that Microsoft Academy enables you to understand research field, not just search for papers. So it has included entity recognition, also query stream context, user context, natural language understanding, everything they have included in this. And then I was just wanted to show you saliency. That is one saliency ranking they have developed, saliency, one metric they have developed. And in this metric, they are saying that lower saliency have not been mentioned in recent publications. So it says that basically, like you cannot measure a particular person's impact only by seeing the citations. That is one premise on which saliency is based. Okay, so each citation based on factors such as citing source, including the reputation and age of the each citation. So where the article has been cited, in which journal the article has been cited, that is also an important. If for example, if you have one publication and that is cited in a very good journal, which means that you have a good impact. Okay, so like other, for example, Google Scholar and other, they measure just citations. So anywhere it is cited, that will be counted as one. But they are giving more weight to those citations which are cited in a reputed or in a established journal or in a good journal. That is why they call it saliency measure. So similarly, they have also called prestige ranking. Prestige ranking that involves more than just the citation, but other factors also they consider, like how many people mention the particular research in social media or other places and how it is discussed. Likewise, that also they have considered. So not going much in detail, but they have also a API also where you can implement in your software also, and you can write down software to access Microsoft API academic and get the results and display it in your software. This is for me, no advanced search. Most of these, you see, they have stopped giving advanced search feature because in the searching itself, they provide Boolean, basically Boolean search they provide, and phrase searching they provide, and other features are embedded in the filters. So from there you can filter it out later also. Like for example, if I search for, I search for COVID-19, then after searching, I can specify whether I want only publication journal publications, or only I want other. If I do not want journal, I want other publications, repository papers. That also I can specify. I can get the only that particular part. So after the search, they are giving more this one to for filtering part. So now this. We will stop here, and then AI. So Dimensions AI is a database that is developed by a company called Digital Science, and this is a very good database, and it has also very good coverage. And here also you can directly search by using whether you want to search in full data or title and abstract and DOI. So you can specify which particular portion you want to search, and then say for example, I want to search only in title and abstract, and here also I want to search metadata quality, and I'll see if I press enter what happens, how many records are retrieved. So I have got 3455 records here, as well as 194 data sets, 826 grants, 784 patents, 11 trials. So you see that a lot of records are available, and they have classified into publication data sets, grants, patents, clinical trials, policy documents, like that. Different. This one they have already. And like Microsoft Academic, they have also defined different research categories or subject categories. Like C08 for information computing science, 0806 information systems, like that. So a classification system they have applied, and on the basis of that you can also see the trend of publications and trend of citations. So you see the mean citation is 10.84 and 37k citations are available, which are the top researchers. You can see from here Soren Auer is the top one of the top researchers that you can see. And source titles means the top journals or conferences which are from where the data is basically available. That also you can see. Similarly, you can also filter the results. So if you are interested only in 2020, it also shows the number of documents that are available. So if you are interested in, say, see, always there will be like in 2019 the highest are there. So if you want to see only those articles which are published in 2019, you can check this one, and only those articles will be displayed. Similarly, if you know some researchers, so you can specify by their researchers also, and then research categories also, field of research. Like there are a lot of field of research they have defined. And say, for example, you are interested in only information systems and this one, then you can limit it to only information systems. Say, for example, biological science, you are not interested, and earth science, you are not interested, then you can specifically select one which is more, you are more interested. Similarly, publication type, you can filter article, proceeding chapter, preprints, monographs, edited books. You can specify if you are interested only in articles, not in proceedings or chapters like that. And source title also, like the name of journals or from where the data they have brought, and the journal list. Journal list is basically sources, like the databases from which, because these search engines, what they do, they go to different databases and collect the metadata and harvest it and store it in a central database from where they provide searching facility. And also you can specify it by using open access, closed access, and gold, green, accept, and submitted, publish. Like that you can, if you are only interested in open access, you can specify. Coming to a particular article, if I click on this, before going to this one, I'll just show you what are the different items that are displayed in the results display page. So apart from the title, which is hyperlink, the author names are displayed, and the particular place where the particular article is published, that is displayed, and the metadata of the abstract is displayed, and number of citations that have received, that are also displayed here. You see, this article has received one citation and four academic, as well as if you PDF also, you can click on PDF and download also from here itself. And if you are interested in a particular article, you can click on that particular article also. And then you can, in detail, you can search by the author name, search by only directly go to the symposium proceeding link, abstract you can read, and number of references it has given, what are the different references that it has given. That also you can see from here. Similarly, you can, in the right side, you can see the different publication metrics. You can export the citation in RIS format so that you can import it in Zotero and other this one. And then it also provides some publication metrics like total citations, how many it has received, recent citations, and funded by which, this research is funded by which particular institution, that also you can see. And then medical subject headings list also they have implemented. And if the full text is available at PMC, or you can download the full text also by clicking here. So this is the record display page where you can see in detail what are the different options. You can see, share it also to somebody through email, through other platforms also you can share. And in the analytics view, you see, if I click on analytics, and I can understand the field also. Like in my academic search also, I could able to understand the fields. So here also I can understand the different research categories, what are the different categories under which the research is conducted. So for example, in metadata quality, information and computing system has maximum records, then information systems has a second number, and then artificial intelligence and image processing. So the, you see, computer software environment, and these are very, very less articles. Or library information studies also has some articles. So if I want, I can specifically click on this and I can see what are the different documents that are available in that particular field. I can filter it by using these filters. I can see what are the articles that are published in this in particular field. Say, for example, if I click on library information studies, I can see what are the top, what are the documents that are published in the field of library information studies in on metadata qualities. Okay, so analytical view is very important because not just papers, it provides a lot of other aspects also. You can see that how the publications on metadata quality has, so in 2013 very few publications are there, whereas with period of time it increases, and now in 2020 it estimated they are showing two publications. And then you can also see the top researchers related to my search, whichever I have searched, what are the top researchers, and clicking on a particular researcher, I can see all the publications by that particular researcher. Say for example, I can see the publication of this particular researcher, and what are the two articles that they have published related to metadata quality. So like that, you see in the they have the query also, they can change. Another important feature I just wanted to show you, I'll show you here from here. Apart from this, these filters, you can directly, you see, you can search for any author also. And Titer and abstract DUI, we all know, there is one feature called abstract search. So in the abstract search, you copy any particular documents abstract, किसी भी आर्टिकल का यू पुट टेक सम से फॉर एग्जांपल जस्ट आई एम टेकिंग दिस वन से फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज वन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आई एम कॉपिंग इट एंड जस्ट पेस्ट द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट हियर सो व्हाट इट डज दैट यू डो नॉट हैव टू वरी अबाउट द कीवर्ड्स एंड अदर थिंग्स लाइक वी हैड सीन इन द जेस्टो टेक्स्ट एनालाइजर फीचर दैट थिंग इज अवेलेबल हियर ऑल्सो So you can see that on the basis of the terms that you have typed here, abstract search, everything it will search in the abstract and it will bring records matching that particular term. Okay, so it has decided that actually the whatever you have pasted, it belongs to medical and health sciences, and accordingly the results are displayed here. And sorting also, I forgot to mention that you can sort the results on the basis of relevance, that is by default, then publication date. And then this is called RCR, means research category and field category ranking, citation wise you can, and altmetric attention score wise you can. So you see they have also developed some kind of another kind of relevance metrics, and they are also giving you opportunity to filter it using that, or sort it by using that particular filter. You see here RCR, they have mentioned somewhere. What is RCR? Research category ratings or something they mention. So like that, you can search academic this. Or also you can register here on Dimensions API, and then you can save the results. Also, you can export these results in the form of CSV files and or in the form of RIS files, so that you can store it in Zotero database. If more than one or many articles, if you want to include, so it will give you option to save also the records. So like that, you can search, try this dimension search. It's a good database. You can try it. And now we'll move to another database called the Scopus database. And Scopus database is basically a very good database. It's a reputed database, and but it is paid. So I'll just share this screen with you. Can you see now? Okay. So Scopus database, it is a paid database, and it has also very good coverage. It is believed that more than 80% of articles that are available are actually available on Scopus database, and it is developed by Elsevier, and that is a good that's a not good but reputed publisher. And here you see you can search by using any keywords directly. Things, for example, if I search by metadata quality itself, say for example, because we are looking only on metadata quality as a keyword, and here you can specify in which particular field you want to search, say article title, abstract keyword, or only in authors, first author, source title. Source title means the name of the journal, article title, only in title you want. You can affiliation, city, country, funding information, language, ISSN code, and DUI references, conference. So lot many things are there, ORCID ID. So say for example, by default we will see, and then I search. So you see here they have the first thing that they show, that how many records are retrieved. So 6,258 documents are results are retrieved, and then they are showing me the query that they have run in the background. So in the title abstract field, they have run metadata, and by default they have put and operator because I have not used any phrase searching. Directly I have used only two keywords, so they thought that these two are by default, they usually apply and operator. So metadata and quality they have searched, and then it shows me the results. So in the result display page, it divides the results in document, secondary document and patents, and then you can sort on date. That by default they have given date newest, but I can specifically ask to sort it by relevance also. So the relevance on the basis of relevant metadata, quality in digital repository, a survey of the current state of the art. You see, the first article itself is very relevant article that has been retrieved by Scopus. That is why Scopus is said that it is a good search engine or good resource for searching the relevant literature. And here I can select the articles, like for example here I can select the articles and then I can export it using RIS, so that I can import it in any reference manager, say Zotero and others. And also I can download it, the records, and view citation overview of these two records, we cited by who cited this documents, or I can save to a list. Since you see I have registered as a user in this Scopus database, so I can save it to a list. I can create several lists and I can save it for future purpose. I can also view the references. I can print the results. I can mail it to myself or somebody else. I can download it as a PDF file, the results, not the document, but results, because it doesn't store any result, any PDF file. See, it will lead you to the publisher where the document is available. So it is just indexing and abstracting database. It will not give you PDF files. Scopus will never give PDF file. It will give you a link to PDF, and if you have subscribed to that resource, you will get the document. So likewise, I can filter also. A lot of filters are available, open access, other, then year wise I can filter, author wise I can filter, and then I can filter by subject area, like earlier we had seen in dimensions and academic also. Subject area wise we can filter. Then document type, publication stage wise, a conference paper articles. So you have 2,503 articles are available. Then source title, keyword wise, affiliation wise. Affiliation means institutional. Like for example, if I want to see Chinese Academy of Science or Center for Scientific something, some institute is there if I want to. And then if I am interested in only Indian articles, then I can click on Indian also. So it will... and then source type and language, and then if I click limit to, it will limit only to the right now it has limited to affiliation country India. You see here, and limit to affiliation country India. So only 20 articles, that 200 articles that are available from India are displayed here. Okay. Then clicking on a particular record, I can see the record display page where I can see where it was published, whether it is open access or not, the volume number, issue number of the document, of the then title of the paper, then author, and then the from the affiliation of the author, from where the author belongs, abstract, and then the they have a called the psi value, that is they have one subject heading list, so that also they show, and then author keywords, what are the keyword author had provided at the time of publication, ISSN number and other details, publisher, and then what are the references. This article has almost 22 references, and what are those references, that also I can if they are indexed in Scopus they will be clickable, and if they are not indexed in Scopus they won't be clickable. So for example, this article is not available in Scopus, that is why I cannot click on this. But you see, this this particular document is available on Scopus, so I can click and see the record of this document and view at publisher also. And it also shows you metrics also, number of times the particular document has been cited, and then which document has cited it. And then you can create an alert also if somebody cites the document. Then related documents, by using some algorithm, they are showing the or other related documents which are which they think that it is related to the this particular paper. Then you can go back to the results, you can save it to PDF also. So this is Scopus, and you can edit and save your search also. So for example, if I save this search, it will ask me by which name you want to search. So for example, this is for example my metadata paper, so I can name it anything. Say I am working on one paper called metadata paper, so I saved it. And now in my account, if I go, I can see my search results, saved searches. You see here, saved searches. So these are the different saved searches that already I had made search, and then those searches are saved, and number of records that were retrieved at that time. And if you want to again search for that, you can click on this button. You do not have to type the same thing again. You can create alert also. This means that you can set a feed, or you can create alert. Means like if a new document, say for example, here 200 documents are available. Say for example, one new document is added on this that matches this query, then one email will be sent to me that a new document has been added in the database that matches your query. So I will be aware, I will be updated of a new article that is published in this particular field. So in that way, you can always be updated about the new findings, about the new articles that are published on your particular area of interest. Coming to the advanced search features of Scopus, and if you see here, it is advanced. They have given. So here you can specify the advanced search features. Here you can see, here they have given some example also, and in this search tips column, you can learn in detail what are the different operators that are available. And in the side wise, they have also shown you the different operators. So if you remember in my classes, I had showed you earlier classes when we were talking about general search techniques, we had discussed about proximity searching. Proximity searching means something in a sentence, like from 5 word distance or 10 words distance. So I had showed you that near, you can use near and other terms. Likewise, you see here pre and W. So W means within, and pre means before, preceded by. So agar koi term 5 shabd pehle aaya ho, theek hai, metadata quality, abhi to jaise metadata quality humne kaha, ab hum chahte hain ki nahi isme within 5 aaya ho, to humne kaha metadata quality 5 shabdon ke antar pe, within 5 words, agar metadata aur quality ek sath aaya hai title aur abstract mein, to aap unko bhi retrieve karo. To ab agar hum dekhe search karenge agar, to ab hamare records jo hain wo चेंज हो गया, नंबर ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स चेंज हो गया. अब हमने एंड ऑपरेटर हटा के अब हमने कर दिया कि मेटाडेटा और क्वालिटी दोनों आना चाहिए एक ही उसमें, बट 5 शब्दों के अंदर में ही आना चाहिए. कहीं ना कहीं मेटाडेटा क्वालिटी, इसी मेटाडेटा क्वालिटी, क्वालिटी ऑफ मेटाडेटा, ऐसा कोई शब्द है तो वो भी आ जाएगा. तो अब देखिए बिल्कुल एग्जैक्ट वही रिकॉर्ड्स आ रहे हैं जो कि हमको चाहिए. और मेटाडेटा क्वालिटी इंटरफेसेस, क्वालिटी मेटाडेटा स्टैंडर्ड्स. तो अगर हम फ्रेज यूज करते हैं तो ये वाला रिट्रीव नहीं होता, क्वालिटी मेटाडेटा ये रिट्रीव नहीं होता. क्यों? क्योंकि विदिन 5 का मतलब है आगे पीछे दोनों तरफ, 5 शब्दों के अंतर पे अगर वो टर्म आ रहा है तो वो रिट्रीव होगा. अब देखिए ये वाला रिकॉर्ड देखिए, इसमें क्या हो रहा है, क्वालिटी मेटाडेटा, पहले क्वालिटी आ गया. अगर हम सिंपल यूज करते, ये देखिए हाई क्वालिटी मेटाडेटा, या मेटाडेटा क्वालिटी, या फिर मेंटेनिंग मेटाडेटा क्वालिटी, और मैं ढूंढ रहा था 2-3 शब्दों के अंतर पे कोई हो. यहाँ पर देखिए, एक्सेसिंग पब्लिक मेटाबोलोमिक्स मेटाडेटा कॉमा टुवर्ड्स इंप्रूविंग क्वालिटी. तो यहाँ पर क्या है, 3-2 शब्द बीच में आ रहे हैं फिर भी ये रिट्रीव हुआ. तो दैट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ प्रॉक्सिमिटी सर्च. तो ऐसे डॉक्यूमेंट्स जहां पर कि जरूरी नहीं है कि दोनों टर्म साथ साथ यूज हो रहे हो, या एंड का मतलब है कि कहीं भी डॉक्यूमेंट में दूर दूर तक अगर क्वालिटी और मेटाडेटा अगर यूज हो रहे होंगे, तो वो भी हमारे लिए बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है. मतलब कि एक ही सेंटेंस के अंदर अगर हम ये यूज करना चाहते हैं तो हम यहाँ 5 देते हैं. अगर हम 20 करना चाहते हैं एडिट करके, 20 अगर हम कर देंगे तो इसका मतलब क्या हो जाएगा, ये 20 वर्ड्स मतलब लगभग एक पैराग्राफ के अंदर अगर मेटाडेटा और क्वालिटी दोनों की बात कर रहे हैं तो वो यूज हो जाएगा। इसी तरह से फील्ड कोड्स यहाँ पे दिए हुए हैं कि अगर जैसे आप कीवर्ड में सर्च करना चाहते हैं या रेफरेंस में करना चाहते हैं या सब्जेक्ट एरिया में करना चाहते हैं तो आप यहाँ से इस पे क्लिक करके उस जैसे ऑल फील्ड्स का मतलब सारे फील्ड में सर्चिंग होगी। सिर्फ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट में करना है तो हम ABS का यूज करेंगे, ठीक है। अगर टाइटल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट में करना है तो हम टाइटल हाइफन ABS का यूज करेंगे। तो जो क्वेरी बनाने की बात की थी हमने, जैसे यहाँ पे देखिए इन्होंने क्या यूज किया है, ये फील्ड कोड यूज किया है टाइटल हाइफन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट हाइफन कीवर्ड। इसका मतलब क्या है कि डॉक्यूमेंट टाइटल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट सब में चूज होगा। तो अगर हम चाहते हैं नहीं ऑथर में भी सर्च हो तो हम ये वाला यूज कर लेंगे। अगर हम चाहते हैं कि नहीं सिर्फ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट में हो तो ABS यूज कर लेंगे। देखिए यहाँ पर इन्होंने जैसे इस क्वेरी को हम समझ लेते हैं, इसका मतलब क्या है कि ऑल फील्ड्स के अंदर कॉग्निटिव आर्किटेक्चर पूरा का पूरा एज ए फ्रेज सर्च करें। क्यों? क्योंकि यहाँ पर डबल कोट्स है एंड ऑथर के नाम में स्मिथ होना चाहिए, ठीक है। फिर टाइटल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट की में कुछ भी हो शुरुआत में, दैट इज वाइल्ड कार्ड, जो हम लोग वाइल्ड कार्ड की बात कर रहे थे कि यहाँ पे स्टार है जिसको हम लोग बोलते हैं ट्रंकेशन सर्च। तो कुछ भी हो सोमैटिक से एंड होना चाहिए वर्ड, कंप्लेंट, वार्म, और फिर यहाँ पर क्वेश्चन मार्क का मतलब है कि सिंगल एक कैरेक्टर को, एंड पब्लिक पब ईयर आफ्टर 1993। ये पब ईयर आफ्टर 1993 आपको कहाँ से मिलेगा? आपको यहाँ से मिलेगा डेट में। अभी यहाँ पे सर्च टिप्स में आप जाएंगे तो आपको डिटेल में मिल जाएगा कि पब ईयर का क्या मतलब है, पब्लिकेशन ईयर जो कि उसकी एक फील्ड है, और आफ्टर का मतलब है AFT का मतलब आफ्टर 1993। और इसी तरह से इशू वाइज भी यू कैन सर्च, पेज वाइज आल्सो यू कैन सर्च, वॉल्यूम अगर आपको पता है तो वॉल्यूम से भी सर्च कर सकते हैं, और सोर्स टाइटल मतलब कि अगर कोई आप जर्नल का नाम सर्च कर रहे हैं जिसके फील्ड जिसमें जो फील्ड से खत्म होता है और ऑर्निथोलॉजी से शुरू होता है वर्ड, ये दोनों वर्ड उसके अंदर होने चाहिए एंड उसका 75वां वॉल्यूम है, इशू 1 है, आप सर्च करना चाहते हैं तो इस तरह से भी आप कर सकते हैं सर्च। तो इसमें डिटेल में अगर आपको थोड़ा सा अगर करना है तो इस पे बहुत सारे इनके ट्यूटोरियल भी अवेलेबल होते हैं, या फिर आप यहाँ से सर्च टिप्स पे क्लिक करके डिटेल में पढ़ सकते हैं कि जो स्कोपस में कैसे सर्च, हाउ कैन आई बेस्ट यूज एडवांस सर्च ऑप्शन, तो आप उसमें पूरा डिटेल में पढ़ सकते हैं। जैसे आपको मैं एक दिखाता हूँ, अगर जैसे यहाँ पे देखिए बुलियन प्रॉक्सिमिटी ऑपरेटर्स आपको यूज करने हैं तो कैसे यूज कर सकते हैं, बुलियन के लिए और है, और ये देखिए विद इन 15, ठीक है, और प्री का मतलब है उससे पहले, सिर्फ पहले के 15 वर्ड्स, और फील्ड कोड्स कौन कौन से फील्ड कोड्स हैं रेफरेंस के लिए, एडवांस सर्च के लिए कौन से फील्ड कोड्स हैं, ठीक है, और अप्रोक्सीमेट फ्रेज वाइल्ड कार्ड कौन कौन से हैं, ये देखिए टाइटल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट हार्ट अटैक से, ये यहाँ पे ये वाइल्ड कार्ड बता रहे हैं लूज फ्रेज। लूज फ्रेज का मतलब है कि अंडर कोट्स में आपने डाल दिया, नॉट ए लूज फ्रेज, अलग अलग शब्द के तौर पे डाल दिया। या फिर आप यहाँ पे देखिए ये जो आपका लेफ्ट ट्रंकेशन है, ये आपका राइट ट्रंकेशन है, वाइल्ड कार्ड्स का यूज करके, स्टार का यूज करके हम कर सकते हैं। एग्जैक्ट फ्रेज में अगर आपको सर्चिंग करनी है तो आप इसको करली ब्रैकेट्स के अंदर रखिए तो एग्जैक्ट फ्रेज में सर्चिंग होगी। तो अलग अलग जैसे हम लोग जो बता रहे थे, डिस्कस भी किया था हमने कि अलग अलग जो डेटाबेसेस हैं उनके अंदर जो सर्चिंग की जो टेक्निक्स को इम्प्लीमेंट करने का जो तरीका है वो अलग अलग है। ठीक है, तो अब यहाँ आज रुकते हैं, स्कोपस हमने देख लिया है और एफिलिएशन वाइज आल्सो यू कैन सर्च किसी एक पर्टिकुलर इंस्टीट्यूशन का नाम है, जैसे हम बाबा साहब भीमराव अम्बेडकर को सर्च करना चाहते हैं। देखिए यहाँ पर आ गया ना बाबा साहब भीमराव अम्बेडकर यूनिवर्सिटी लखनऊ, तो यहाँ पे अगर हम सर्च करना चाहते हैं तो ये हमको दिखा रहा है कि इसमें स्कोपस में 1654 आर्टिकल हैं जो कि बाबा साहब भीमराव अम्बेडकर यूनिवर्सिटी के ऑथर्स के द्वारा पब्लिश हैं, जिसमें 562 ऑथर्स जो हैं वो लिस्टेड हैं। और इसके बाद कौन से टॉप के जो हैं, जैसे एनवायरमेंटल साइंस है सबसे ऊपर है, इंजीनियरिंग है, एग्रीकल्चर है, ये आप यहाँ से देख सकते हैं कि कौन से फील्ड्स के जो हैं वो सबसे ज़्यादा पब्लिकेशन हो रहे हैं, और ऐसे ही आप यहाँ पर डिवाइड कर सकते हैं। अच्छा एक फीचर छूट गया है, मैं आपको वो दिखाता हूँ आपको, देन किससे किससे कोलैबोरेट कर रहे हैं यहाँ के जो यूनिवर्सिटी के रिसर्चर्स हैं, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ लखनऊ से कोलैबोरेट कर रहे हैं, पीजे
PGI से कर रहे हैं, BHU से कर रहे हैं, कौन कौन से इंस्टीट्यूशन से इनका कोलैबोरेशन है ये देख सकते हैं, कौन से जर्नल्स हैं जो ज्यादा पॉपुलर हैं, जैसे एडवांसेस इन ये हैं वो, तो ये जैसे लाइब्रेरी के लिए जैसे लाइब्रेरी पीपल हैं वो सब्सक्रिप्शन लेना चाहते हैं तो वो यहाँ से देख के डिसाइड कर सकते हैं कि ये टॉप के 10 जर्नल हैं जो सबसे ज्यादा यहाँ पे छपवा रहे हैं लोग, तो इनको सब्सक्राइब कर लिया जाए ताकि उनको आसानी से अपने पेपर्स मिल सके। एक फीचर है जो छूट गया अभी, देखिए याद आया बातचीत में, अगर हम कोई सर्च यहाँ पे कर रहे हैं, जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल हमने यहीं पे सर्च किया, तो एक टैब आता है एनालाइज सर्च रिजल्ट्स, तो जो सर्च रिजल्ट्स हैं उनको आप एनालाइज कर सकते हैं, तो अगर आप इसको क्लिक करें तो आप इसमें एनालिसिस कर सकते हैं कि जो आपके 1000 रिकॉर्ड जो रिट्रीव हुए हैं वो रिकॉर्ड्स की क्या स्ट्रेंथ है, मतलब कि ईयर वाइज वो बढ़ रहे हैं, नंबर ऑफ इस फील्ड में जो पब्लिकेशन है वो कौन से हैं, मतलब जो आपके सबसे एक पुराना आर्टिकल है वो 1991 का है, सबसे नया आर्टिकल 2020 का भी अवेलेबल है जो आपने सर्च किया उसमें, ठीक है। और इसमें फिर अदर मेट्रिक्स आप देख सकते हैं कि डॉक्यूमेंट बाय सब्जेक्ट एरिया कौन से हैं, फंडिंग एजेंसी यूरोपियन कमीशन से कौन से हैं, यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स कौन सी कंट्री से सबसे ज्यादा पब्लिकेशन मिले हैं आपको, इस तरह से आप एक एनालिसिस चाहें तो अपना यहाँ पे कर सकते हैं, या आप स्पेसिफाई करना चाहें कि भाई नहीं 91 से नहीं हमको चाहिए, हमको लास्ट 10 ईयर्स का ही डेटा चाहिए, तो आप यहाँ से क्लिक करके एनालाइज कर सकते हैं, लास्ट 10 ईयर्स के डेटा को भी एनालाइज कर सकते हैं। तो आप लास्ट 10 ईयर का डेटा को अगर आप देखेंगे तो वो कुछ इस तरह के हैं आपके स्टडीज, ज़्यादातर जो हैं आपके पास 80 के आसपास आर्टिकल जो हैं वो अवेलेबल हैं हर ईयर में लगभग, और ऐसे ही आप देख सकते हैं कि कौन से सब्जेक्ट एरिया में सबसे ज़्यादा हैं, इस पर क्लिक करके वो बड़ा हो जाएगा, कंप्यूटर साइंस में सबसे ज़्यादा हैं, उसके बाद सोशल साइंसेज में हैं, मैथमेटिक्स इंजीनियरिंग के हैं और बायोमेडिकल साइंस के हैं, अदर्स के हैं, तो इस तरह से आप इसमें स्पेसिफिक फील्ड वाइज भी देख सकते हैं कि किस फील्ड के कितने ज़्यादा हैं, मतलब कि अगर आप कोई रिसर्च टॉपिक डिसाइड कर रहे हैं तो आप अपने रिसर्च टॉपिक को यहाँ पहले सर्च करके आप देख सकते हैं कि उसमें क्या ट्रेंड है, उसमें रिसर्च हो भी रही है कि नहीं हो रही है, कि कहीं ऐसा तो नहीं है कि उसमें सब रिसर्च हो चुकी है या अब उस पर बहुत इंटरेस्ट नहीं है लोगों का, तो आप उसको एनालाइज कर सकते हैं अपने सर्च रिजल्ट्स को और चेक कर सकते हैं कि अब इसमें आगे फ्यूचर में जो अगर ट्रेंड जो है वो बढ़ता हुआ है तो आप उस फील्ड को ले लीजिए, अगर ट्रेंड बढ़ता हुआ नहीं है तो उसमें कम चांसेस हैं कि आपकी आपको उसमें ज़्यादा पॉपुलैरिटी मिलेगी, ज़्यादा आप अच्छा काम कर पाएंगे या फिर ज़्यादा पब्लिकेशंस हो पाएंगे आपके। ठीक है, फिर कोई क्वेश्चन है आप लोग का?